It's all right here. Welcome back. Today is International Women's Day, a day we celebrate the amazing things that women are doing all around the world, from raising families, running companies, pioneering innovation, driving humanitarian causes. The list is endless.
It goes on and on. But even with so many advancements, women are still significantly underrepresented in the technology workforce and leave technology at alarmingly high rates, despite a growing number of high-demand, unfilled tech jobs.
Well, we have Sydney and Julie here from the Women Tech Council to tell us about new research that just came out today. Okay. Tell us more about why there is such a gap in when it comes to, I guess, the workforce.
That's right. Now, this is the mission of the Women Tech Council, mm-hmm. right? How do we increase the number of women in technology and attract and retain them? And so, as an organization, we released this research report today, and it comes from all of the experience and the research that we've done over the last decade, really, to understand what it is companies need to do in order to make sure that they can attract and retain talent. And, you know, what are those gaps?
Why is there such a gap? What is believed to be, Julie, I'll hand that to you, why is there such a gap?
Well, what we're finding is that companies need to have comprehensive programs to really support diversity and inclusion. For example, one of the first things we found in our research, that executive engagement is crucial to building the culture from the top down. A good example of that is Workfront, one of our leading high-tech growth companies, is they had an executive commitment to pay parity. And they wanted to ensure that they had equality across their organization. So they did an exhaustive study. They found they were in pretty good shape, made a few adjustments. And what I love about what they did is they immediately made those adjustments. They didn't wait for the next budget cycle. And that's all a result of the executive commitment they have around ensuring, you know, pay equality across their organization.
What other things did you find as you guys were going through compiling this report?
Yeah, so the second in these four factors, second one was around company programming. So companies have to have many very specific programs that create inclusive cultures. Example of that is Pluralsight. So they take every job description through a gender decoder to ensure that those jobs attract the right candidates. One of the other ones
we found that it is external community involvement around diversity and inclusion initiatives. For example, Dell EMC works with organizations like GirlStart, SheTech, and other organizations that really care about supporting coding. And what's great about that is that sends a message to employees in the organization that diversity inclusion is really important, but also has helped building the workforce of the future.
Okay,
and tied to that is, if the companies that have diversity and inclusion groups, so women's groups and diversity groups that are working together internally to understand. Now, those aren't groups of only women. Right. They are groups that include men and women from the top down that are understanding what's going on in that current company, and they're addressing those, and then we elevate those best practices. As the companies weave those four factors together, those companies are attracting and retaining talent. And when they don't do those integrated programs, they're really struggling to attract and retain that talent, and women are leaving.
How do you get this report into the companies for them to recognize where maybe they're falling short?
Yeah, I mean, this type of information has to go top down. It has to go to every person in the organization, because to change culture starts at the top, but it involves every one of us, right? And it's all of our responsibility to create a voice that is, how do we leverage the talent? Yeah. How do we create great performing teams? And we do it not by one program. We do it by an entire mindset that inclusivity leads to the best performance, the best talent, and the best teams.
And where can we find all this information if anybody is interested? Because I'm sure there are a lot of people saying, well, wait a second, this sounds good.
I need to take this to my boss.
Where can we grab it?
Yeah, absolutely. So this report is on womentechcouncil.com or .org, either one, if you go there right now. We also released today three best practices. So some of those very specific programs we mentioned, they're also documented so that companies can follow similar things. And we believe in just lifting the whole community. Like, what's working? Let's all do that together.
Love it. Well, Sid and Julie, thank you so much for being here and sharing the new report with us, and hopefully that will change the culture. We'll get it going.
Exactly. And appropriate on